Where there is hate, that I may bring love. Where there is offence, that I may bring pardon. Where there is discord, that I may bring union. Where there is error, that I may bring truth. Where there is doubt, that I may bring faith. Where there is despair, that I may bring hope. Where there is darkness, that I may bring light. Where there is sadness, that I may bring joy. O Master, make me not so much to be consoled as to console, not so much to be loved as to love, not so much to be understood as to understand. For it is in giving that one receives, it is in self-forgetfulness that one finds, it is in pardoning that one is pardoned, it is in dying that one finds eternal life. Prayer of St. Francis of Assisi. As we light this chalice, may this gathering for worship enlighten our hearts, our minds, our souls, and the candle burn brightly to lighten our way. Autumn finds a reminder of the warmth we share in fellowship, the burning logs, the resurrection of life from the ashes. The light from the fire is symbol of the light within us and around us. And may the inner light of the Spirit be kindled by our time together. Amen. Welcome to Cairo Street Chapel. My name is Leslie Lewis. Cairo Street Chapel follows in the tradition of the Unitarian and Free Christian Church in promoting a free and inquiring religion open to all beliefs. And people have been meeting here since 1662, and I am very pleased to be able to lead the service today. So today is the 1st of November, All Saints' Day. The season of All Hallows' Tide, the 3 days of All Hallows' Eve, All Hallows' Day, and All Souls' Day. It's time to honour the saints, our ancestors, and our loved ones who are no longer with us, to reflect on how we can find faith in these uncertain times. Welcome. Our first hymn is Pilgrim's Hymn, Who Would You Fellow See? And the words can be found in the booklet that the piece is very kindly done, and if you're following from home, the words will be found on the screen. Pilgrim's Hymn, Who Would You Fellow See?
Oh,
My first reading is taken from the Pilgrim's Progress by the English writer John Bunyan. As I walked through the wilderness of this world, I lighted on a certain place where a den was, and laid me down in that place to sleep. And as I slept, I dreamed a dream. I dreamed, and behold, I saw a man clothed with rags, standing in a certain place, with his face from his own house, a book in his hand, and a great burden upon his back. I looked and saw him open the book and read therein, and as he read, he wept and trembled. And not being able longer to contain, he broke out with a lamentable cry, saying, "What shall I do? What shall I do?" Some of us may face the dark nights of our souls, and the Pilgrim's Progress by John Bunyan is a symbolic vision of one man's pilgrimage through life. And in a world that has seen so many changes, finding faith in these uncertain times is something we may find challenging and even hard to do. There may be times when we may experience contrasting emotions and feelings. We may have days when we say we are okay, but inside we may be feeling lost, lonely, overwhelmed, frightened. When we feel we have strayed off our path of life, we can ask for inner guidance to find what brings purpose, to seek what is meaningful in our lives. My second reading is by an unknown author, but it's about letting go. To let go isn't to forget. It's not to think about or to ignore. It doesn't mean feelings of anger, jealousy, or regrets. Letting go isn't about winning or losing. It's not about pride, and it's not about how you appear. And it's not about obsessing or dwelling on the past. Letting go isn't blocking memories or thinking sad thoughts. And it doesn't leave emptiness, hurt, or sadness. It's not about giving in or giving up. Letting go isn't about loss, and it's not about defeat. To let go is to cherish the memories, but to overcome and move on. It is about having an open mind and confidence in the future. Letting go is learning and experiencing and growing. To let go is to be thankful for the experiences that made you laugh, made you cry, and made you grow. It's about all that you have, all that you hold, and all that you will soon gain. Letting go is having the courage to accept change and the strength to keep moving on. Letting go is growing up. It is realising that the heart can sometimes be the most potent remedy. To let go is to open a door and to clear a path and set yourself free. And now, when we listen to the Lord's Prayer, let us reflect on the words, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name." May we think of hallowed as all that is holy and sacred. The Lord's Prayer.
Thank you.
We just have just the one notice this week, and that's just to say that spiritual discernment group will be online on Wednesday. And if anyone is interested in attending, to please contact Alan Smith or one of our committee members. The spiritual discernment will be online on Wednesday. And I've just been passing off a notice that our lovely Sue Blythe is in self-isolation for, has she had the eye operation?
She
lives
in self-isolation.
Oh, well, she's having an eye operation. So when we come to sending out our prayers for healing, that we will send out a mention for Sue as well. So I'll mention that again. Our second hymn today is Named Unnamed, and the words, again, if you're following from home, can be found on the screen or can be found on the booklet. Beautifully moving, ceaselessly forming, growing, emerging with awesome delight. Maker of rainbows, glowing with colour, arching in wonder, energy flowing in darkness and light. Named, unnamed, hidden and shown, knowing and known, Gloria, named and named.
Name unnamed, hidden and shown.
there in the communion of prayer, you may wish to close your eyes. Loving Spirit, help us this day to find stillness, to rest our busy minds. Let this day be an opportunity to develop patience, tolerance, compassion, wisdom, and make us an instrument of thy peace. To see the divinity within ourselves, to love, respect our neighbour and the world around us. Give us the strength where there is hate, we may bring love. Not to lose faith, but courage to face each new day. Where there is darkness, we will bring light. To be humble in our hearts and in our ways, to feel your presence in our life, and to remember you are always with us. We ask today for healing, for sweet life, and keep up in our thoughts. And to remember all our loved ones, family and community, our prayers go out to them. We also ask for compassion for all those who need help, love and understanding, who are suffering in body, mind or spirit. Enfold them in the love of the Goddess energy. And we ask this for your divine grace. Amen. We will now have a time for reflection with a piece of music that I will think you will like by Ella Jones.
As we welcome the month of November, the clocks have gone back an hour, the daylight is fading, and there is a noticeable Christmas in the air. The season of bonfires and fireworks is upon us, and we pay homage to the saints, to our ancestors, our loved ones who are no longer with us. But we remember too all those who have gone before us, inspiring us with their courage and faith. In A Pilgrim's Progress by John Bunyan, a symbolic vision of one good man's pilgrimage through life. When challenges are present in our lives, we need to find a way to connect to source, to help us to disconnect from what is no longer serving us, to know we are not alone, to find faith in Christ consciousness. We all have the capacity to connect to the universe or whatever higher force you believe in, for the strength to love to our full potential. We may put faith in prayer to the saints or to the Divine Mother, whose energy runs through every belief system in the world. In India, she is seen as Shakti and Parvati. In the East, she is Kuan Yin. And in many other places, she is seen as Mary. With her nurturing and loving spirit, for help, for healing, protection and comfort. In our time of need, wrapped and secure in her love, fills our energy like a cup so that we can feel whole again. To take inspiration from the stories and legends passed down through the ages, to the saints who lived in the midst of difficulties, uncertainty and suffering. Despite these circumstances, they made extraordinary choices to put faith into action. And there are many, many saints, but the one most close to my heart is the Italian religious leader, St. Francis of Assisi, who founded the religious order known as the Franciscans. He became renowned for his love, simplicity, and practice of poverty, and is also the patron saint of animals, and whose prayer we heard at the beginning. Late autumn, with fireworks light up our night sky, the night of November the 5th is observed in Britain with bonfires to celebrate the capture in 1605 of a group of people who planned to destroy the buildings of Parliament. We may know them as Skyfolks. And Diwali, the Indian festival of lights, usually lasted 5 days and celebrated between mid-October and mid-November. One of the most popular festivals of Hinduism. Diwali symbolises the spiritual victory of light over darkness, good over evil, and knowledge over ignorance. And welcomes home Lord Rama from the story of Rama and Sita. But Celtic people have had a long understanding that both darkness and light were part of their lives. And this time of year, it is hard not to notice all the merchandise in the shops. Sweets for trick-and-treating, dressing up costumes, plastic skeletons to goodie stores, decoration for inside and outside our homes, pumpkins for carving and apples for bobbing, although this year it has been slightly different. But the commercialisation of Halloween started sometime in the 1900s. And then costumes started to appear in the stores a little later, followed by the custom of trick-or-treating. But Halloween takes its name from All Hallows' Eve, the night before All Saints' Day. Halloween's origins date much further back to the ancient Celtic festival of Samhain, when it was a time to celebrate the final harvest and the end of the yearly cycle, before the dormant sleepy time of frost and darkness, so it can be seen for many as their new year. It's also tied that symbolises death before rebirth and was usually held on around the 31st of October, which is why we celebrate it now. It's time to remember our ancestors, to decorate an altar, laying a place at our table, burning a candle, and making a toast in our honour. But our loved ones are never far from thought. They live on in our hearts, our memories, in the smell of certain foods that you remember, flowers that you pick, the fragrance of life itself. They live on in our children's faces, of Christmas time, birthdays, and family holidays. The place that you came from, your first home, your first love, your first friend. It may be an ornament that you bought, the band of a gold of a wedding ring. And today's service, there will be a tribute to all our loved ones who have passed away in the form of a photographic montage. But nothing on earth can separate that bond of love. Not time, not space, not even death. And on the 11th hour of the 11th day, of the 11th month, when the bugle plays the last post, in that 2 minute silence, we shall not forget the 37 million people who lost their lives in the course of the Great War, World War I. We observe Remembrance Day to pay tribute to those who sacrificed their lives in order to offer a better future for younger generations, to the soldiers, the civilians, and people working behind the lines, and to all those who died in the many, many wars since. To our loved ones who lost their lives. And so on the 11th of November, we honour and we give thanks for the tremendous sacrifices made by those who have gone before us. And as we think of death, we think of life and all that sustains us. Autumn teaches us how beautiful it is to let go, as we heard in the reading. And sometimes it is not in the holding on that makes us strong, it is in the letting go. Sometimes in our life, we have to let go. It takes a lot of courage and inner strength. It might be a relationship, our home, our employment, or a loved one. Letting go may even be old habits and thought patterns, old ways of doing things that don't work anymore. The COVID pandemic has changed the way we live. We need to learn to adjust, to find faith in each other, in people we don't know, but most of all, faith in ourselves. Letting go is about accepting what is happening right now and not worrying about what will come up tomorrow. It's about finding faith in these uncertain times. We may at times not have faith in our government or our politicians, but we do have faith in our doctors and nurses, in the staffs who work under the NHS. Faith in the people and organisations that work behind the scenes to make our living conditions better. And this week, we have seen many people pull together so no child goes hungry during half term. On cold, misty, damp, foggy mornings of November, we are glad to put our heating on, but spare a thought for those who may not have money to buy a hot drink, food, or even a roof over their heads. To experience faith in each other and in humanity when at times it feels impossible or even pointless. And November the 15th to the 22nd of 2020 is recognised as End Hunger Week and sees the movement to end hunger and homelessness. Health and Justice is a small, highly influential national charity whose work makes a huge difference to thousands of people who stay at night shelters across the country, or those who are helped in some other ways by churches, community groups and volunteers. Without which, the Rustic Sleep account will be staggering 40% higher. Now, we may never really know the true impact we have on those around us, or how much kindness turns someone else's life around. And from the words, we shall be known by the company we keep, by the ones who circle round to tend these fires. We shall be known by the ones who sow and reap. The seeds of change alive from deep within the earth. It is time now. It is time now that we thrive. It's time we lead ourselves into the world. It is time now. And what a time to be alive. In this great turning, we should learn to lead and love. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead and love. Long after the joyful celebrations of autumn ends, and the last of the fireworks light up the night sky, long after the warm crackling sounds are but a distant reminder of the dying embers from the autumn bonfires, the smoke lingers in the air. In planters' fields where the poppies once grew, sacrifices made long ago by those who have gone before us. Heartfelt memories of loved ones past, the sepia photos now faded. The sleepless saints nod to traditions long past, choosing stars from far off galaxies and distant moons, first streaks of a new dawn. The essence of life will live on. Our closing music, We Shall Be Known by Mummies.
We shall be known by the company we keep, by the ones who circle round to tend these fires. We shall be known by the ones who sow and reap the seeds of change alive from deep within the earth. It is time now. It is time now that we thrive. It is time we lead ourselves into the well. It is time now, and what a time to be alive. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love. We shall be known by the company we keep, by the ones who circle round to tend these fires. We shall be known by the ones who sow and reap the seeds of change alive from deep within the earth. It is time now. It is time now that we thrive. It is time we lead ourselves into the well. It is time now, and what a time to be alive. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in thou. In this great turning we shall learn to lead in thou. In this great turning we shall learn to lead in thou.
I'll close in prayer. Divine Spirit, help us to learn to lead with love and in fellowship, with tolerance, compassion, and respect for all living on the earth. Where there is darkness, help us to bring light. In despair, help us to bring hope. With thy grace, help us to have faith in this changing world we live in and we call home. May we learn how to walk wisely from the saints, our ancestors, our loved ones, and those gone before us, from the examples of faith, dedication, and love. Amen. Our final piece of music is a blessing for everyone present in our life and in memory of all our loved ones who are no longer with us. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rain fall softly on your fields. And until we meet again, may you keep safe in the gentle, loving arms of God.
Thank you.